Hey guys, so in this video I'm going to run through some of the common mistakes that many of us tend to do when we recite the Medha Suktam. I'm referring to the version from the Krishna Yajurveda and also the part where the invocation is added, meaning before Medha Devi Jushamana Agar, there will be an invocation which sounds like Yas Chandasam, so that's a Shanti mantra. And I'll be including some corrections in that too. So the first one would be obviously the first verse in the Shanti mantra itself. Yas chandasam rishabho vishvarupaha. So intonation marking, many make a mistake here. They bring the higher pitch to a lower one so as to make it sound as yas chandasam. So this is how they usually make it. Yas chandasam. It's actually yas chandasam rishabho. Right? And next would be the usage of Mahaprana. Medha Suktam is full with hard consonant, or what we know as Mahaprana, where the sound is very hard. So if you're using an English script, take note that the places where the H is added, for example, even in Medha, the spelling would be M-E-D-H-A. So wherever there's D-H-A, B-H-A, you make sure that when you pronounce it as an exhalation with a force in there, like Bha, Dha, and not just Da, that would be an Alpa Prana, soft consonant. So Medha Suktam is filled with hard consonants, a lot of them, and make sure that you stress wherever necessary. For example, just as an example, even in the Shanti mantra itself, Yas chandasam rishabho vishvarupaha chando bhyo dhyamritaat. Even the dhyamritaat, the taat ends with a H, T-A-T-H, so it's dhyamritaat sambhuva samendro medhaya sprunotu. So wherever necessary, just give the blast there, right? So the next mistake would be in the elongation of the vowel. So there'll be one part where it comes as Tvaya Jushta Rishir Bhavati Devi Tvaya. So the Jushta before Rishir is it's just Jushta Rishir. It is not Jushta Rishir. This is a very common mistake. Probably this is where most make mistakes, because the previous lines that have a similar pattern where it comes as Jushta Nudamana or something, there the Jushta is elongated at the end. But in the case of Rishir, it is shortened. It comes together with Rishir so as to make it sound as Tvaya Jushta Rishir, and it is not Tvaya Jushta Rishir that is wrong. It should be Jushta Rishir. That the in Jushta, it's short. Jushta Rishir. So, and next would be the pronunciation of the dhatu in the line of Medham Indro Dadatu Medham Devi Saraswati. So in this verse particularly, it is not Dadatu. It's a soft consonant here, so it is the English equivalent spelling would be D-A-D-A-T-U. So it should be Dadatu, and it is not Dadatu, because this sound Dadatu comes in many places and it is pronounced as Dadatu. The Dha is added there. But in this example, in this particular verse, it is just Dadatu. So Medham Indro Dadatu Medham Devi Saraswati. Right? So the last common mistake would be in the last line, which sounds most interesting, when it comes as Mayi Medha Mayi Prajam Mayi Yagnis Tejo Dadatu Mayi Medha Mayi Prajam Mayi Indra Indriyam Dadatu. So the common mistake many people make is in the line of the Indra Indriyam. It is supposed to be Indra Indriyam, and so the Indra Indriyam should be Indra Indriyam. Only the dra should go up. So what many people make as a mistake is they do it as Mayi Medha Mayi Praja Mayi Indra Indriyam. should the indra indriyam, the first part should be a flat pitch, a middle pitch. So indra, only the dra should go up. Indra indriyam, in should be a middle pitch. What many people tend to do is they bring the in indra in a lower pitch. So it should be indra and not indra. Indra indriyam. Yeah, before I forget, thank God I recall that. Another common mistake would be apsara. Apsara suchaya medha gandharveshu chayanmanaha. In that line, the apsara pronunciation, up and sa, up, sa, the two sounds are in lower pitch. Apsara, ra is middle pitch, and su is higher pitch. So it should be sounding as something like apsara suchaya. What many people tend to do is they bring this up sa in the middle pitch. It's actually a lower pitch. Apsara. Right? So up and sa is a lower pitch. Apsara suchaya. And of course gandharveshu. Gandharveshu. Ga gan is higher pitch. And dhar is lower. So many people do not bring the gan in a higher pitch. They make it a middle pitch. So the emphasis is not really there. So it should be gandharveshu cha yanmanaha. Right? And not gandhar. Gandhar. Gan is middle. Gandhar. Gan is a higher pitch. So these are the common mistakes that some of us tend to do in Medha Suktam. So probably the most important point to take note is Medha Suktam is the occurrence of Mahaprana in many places. Make sure that you stress the sound, and that itself contributes to the beauty of chanting the Medha Suktam. Even just use the Medha, pronounce the Dha hard in Medha, that itself will be beautiful. When you emphasize all these parts, it makes Medha Suktam really beautiful and quite unique by itself in comparison to many other Vedic chants. So in the descriptions I've added a link where you can learn the Medha Suktam, and if you want any help in or aid into or guidance to learn the Medha Suktam, you can just comment them, right? So thank you for watching.